Fried Simpsons. Oh. What the heck was... Wait. What just happened? That was a little weird. Hello, Bright Simpsons 7 here, and I'm just checking one thing real quick to make sure my move set is right. That's not the one I equipped. Is it? Yeah, you know, that is. Alright, just checking everything real quick, make sure everything was the same in this as it was in the other version. Hello. Well, hello, Project 77 here. I'm sorry for my lack of recent recordings. If you recall, I mentioned starting a certain series in my last video. This was the planned series, but I never got around to it before the end of summer. Now that school was started, I have my privileges back. That's ironic, as I know, but, you know, my parents didn't want me doing some work. And what I wanted to do was I wanted to do all the story modes in Hopeless Masquerade on normal mode in the English patch in an attempt to show, you know, do the story and things like that. Hopefully some people, you know, find that interesting, yeah. Yeah, I'll just be doing them in order on the normal difficulty since I'm not an expert with all characters, but at this point, yeah. Let's just start. No need to elaborate. Now it's lagging a bit. I already know this from before. My early videos. Unlike the actual, unlike, you know, player versus player in this, when you are fighting in the story mode, how it works is they're divided into two segments of each match type. Yeah. And I'm gonna get my... Yeah, I need to be careful about that. Don't remember this one. Oh, I need to be close enough to execute that properly. Looks like I didn't have that moveset, so I like spend a ton of time in the actual Japanese version making a ton of custom movesets and things like that, but... Spell break. One second. And it's gonna be lagging a bit. This is because already Hopeless Masquerade has a high CPU usage for a computer with 4 gigabytes of RAM. Combine this with fraps, and you don't get exactly the best things. Yeah. Dang, I can't remember the people who made the English patch, but thank you for doing it. I don't remember who made it, though. They had a name. I feel like an idiot. I'm gonna feel like a major idiot. The mic's not turned on. I've been talking to myself this whole time. Thank goodness the mic's on. Now, to understand the whole concept behind these fights, you have to think. Wait, whoa, what just happened? Okay, this is a first. The music just stopped. Oh well, I guess no music then! What was that? I just don't know why the music stopped. I think it's a bug. I don't know. I do not want to get stuck in whatever that is. Reimu is not my best character, I'm gonna tell you that right now. This is strange. It was like the theme played for 2 seconds and then it stopped. This is scary, actually. Let's see if I can actually hit it this time. Dang it, I miss. And then, how it usually works is it's a normal round of fighting, and then it goes alternating back and forth until they reach their last stand. And it's like, kinda creepy almost. Right now, because of the silence and all. This is a very interesting bug. I've never seen anything like this happen before. Landed it. Now her attacks are gonna deal like increased damage for a little bit, so. That's a very strange bug. That's the first time that's ever happened in my entire course of playing this game. Yeah. You alternate between two victory animations. Oh, and this transition at the end, if you know more about the game series, you'd probably know what that is. Now, you all know the plot from watching the intro, but yeah, that's pretty much it. It's a religious warfare in a way. For those who don't understand, Feng Shui does not just refer to decorating. I'm gonna tell you that right now. If you think it does, please leave this video. Well, not really. You could learn a thing or two. Oh, great. back. This is why I don't like playing on normal. I don't block as much and things like that. But I decided to do it on normal because, you know, I'm not good with all the characters. Nailed it! What? Also, the one thing that bothers me is the AI is not using the... And then their last resort, which is... Oh. Now, they're actually using attacks that they don't often use in normal mode. It's actually a reference there, I think. I don't know what the reference is. Let's try this again! Except land at this time. Oh, you have to kick it! Yeah. If you're not careful, that move can actually be devastating. Normally, when you're using Budo and player versus player, or computer versus player, you actually will, one of her optional attacks is a bow, is using a bow. Although the attack is impractical. Ever, but still. I need to use that earlier. Why didn't I just use that earlier? I don't know. Oh, for all those who are wondering, brief explanation of the HUD. You have your, basically your stamina in a way, or your mental capability thing. Focus, whatever it is. That goes down as you fight, or use special attacks, or block, or something like that. When blocking, however, it won't deplete your, the one that you're using. And I skipped that conversation entirely, dang it. I don't read these, by the way, because I cannot do female, I cannot do women's voices, and I'm pretty sure everyone knows this already, unless I think I've tried before on camera. So the Shrug Man's only concern with beating the crap out of everyone as usual. Yeah, if you know about... At least the AI don't use a Biak. At least they don't use the rushdown strategy when using this character, because that's really obnoxious. Rushdown is when you use Biak for rush. Yeah, do that through the opponent and attack them from behind. And also, in the upper corner is popularity. What happens when you max popularity out? Well, yeah, you gain positive and negative depending on certain things happening. That's not gonna work. Get over here. Okay, fine. Now, I don't know how to use Reimu as a special mechanic or anything, but I know Byakuya's just basically spamming. Your attacks become more powerful as you spam. Oh crap. That did not turn out well at all. Just destroy everything. I swear that move is so overpowered, I just can't tell why. Oh, normal phase of combat, then another round, that's right, for this boss. Sorry for skipping that cutscene earlier, you can pause it and thank the looks and what they were saying though. Also, I think that's a texture error, there's supposed to be something on those black, what appear to be pillars, signs. There's supposed to be writing on them, and there is in the other version, it's just not appearing right now for some reason. I think it's a bug. Something to do with the patch, I don't know. No idea what this one is. Oh. Oh, and I can't use that ability again. What did I just do? I think that's actually a trap. What? Let's see if I can pull this off again. It's hard! If I die here, I'm not surprised. I think I did last time I tried this too. Well, anyway, what I'll be doing is I'll be clearing all the stories on normal mode, which is something I haven't done before. I haven't cleared all the stories before. Including for the lock characters, or the two additional characters that you can't play as at the beginning for some reason. I will also be showing the English version of the endings for those who have not seen it. See, there are two possible victory poses for each character. You'll probably see them all throughout this walkthrough, just by winning or losing things like that. Translation failed, or no, actually I don't think so. I think faithful can refer to a religion or someone who's faithful to a religion or like a combination of that. No, it really isn't. It is... no. Oh, this one. This is actually a bit of a joke. You see, as your popularity gains, you actually deal slightly more damage as well. So, yeah. Also, for those who recognize this theme, good for you. That is how you combo. Now, for those who are wondering, no, this... Did I just see that? Really? Oh, she also says that as earlier. No, that character does not normally have the ability to enlarge herself, so yes, it's an illusion. Spoilers. Next scene. This trickster, I already... supposed to be the third most powerful Nuki or something like that. Esmo Futatsuiwara is very powerful. Not in a sense of raw power, but in a sense of her ability to disguise with people and to deceive is her advantage. This one. Now this is basically a normal fight, but the opponent has more health. Yeah, except don't let the leaves touch you, yeah. Because, surprise. Well, actually, it's interesting, really. If she goes near any leaves, they will turn into them. Dang it. Looks like I won't pull that off. Just basically just spam the same keys you'll eventually pull. Now she has three cards, if I remember correctly. She has two main attacks, and then she has her final one. You'll see what I'm saving it for. No, this spell card is annoying to high heaven. You'll excuse me. The last one's easy to survive, this one not so much. -49%. Yes, how it works is various things get you more. Oh, this one's the annoying one. Or so you would think. All I have to do is dash through it. That should make me lose popularity for that. No? And then I die. I almost always lose a life there anyway, so yeah, that's not a surprise at all. Yeah, I take a ton of damage because of that, yeah. Now it shouldn't take me two lives on the actual boss, though. Meanwhile, at midnight. Yeah, I actually never really paid that much attention to plot, and yes, they're all wearing masks. Yeah, so yoga has the ability to do this. It's actually kind of creepy, really. I wasn't even expecting that, to be honest. I've never played the English translation of this. Lost. True. Mask of Hope. A New Hope. think this is bad? Just look at Netplay on this. The lag is terrible. Yeah. Lost her mask of hope, assuming it was stolen. Yeah, that's really one of the advantages of playing Reimu, to do that, but that's it. Actually really damage you if not careful. Easy to dodge, but it's trickier to land hits. That's the only drawback. It's the only hard part about that spell. The AI does this on normal mode for some reason. It'll just stand still. I don't know why. They actually do it a lot. On normal mode only, though, I think on easy mode too, the AI stands still waiting for you to come to them. I don't know why. Now, I think... Okay, here comes the hard one. This one I usually just barely survive. You can't dash through it. This is the key thing, so you have to just avoid it. You'll notice it will follow a certain pattern. Thus, by going to the left and right of the screen, you can actually avoid contact with it in the first place. Now, normally I just time this one out, because really there's no other way to do it, to be honest. It's just... you have to hope for the best. Goes right, left, right, unless you're on the far side of a screen during the time. What you do is you stay in the center until it comes in, at least on normal. And then you dash across the screen as it starts to come in, or right before it does. You get the timing down after, like, one or two failed attempts. Also, you can see her masks follow her onto the screen very briefly. For the first part, at least. Holy crap, I almost died. You also need to be careful because it will force you up into it, actually, during the progress of the spell. If you get caught in the jaws, it will force you up into the jaws, and it'll deal a whole lot of damage, taking out about pretty much half your health. I don't know what this one is. Oh, that's her final one, isn't it? I need to be careful here. I thought her final spell card was called Hopless Masquerade, but... translation fail much. I think it's actually got different names at different parts. But the battle is the same every time. Actually, very hard to beat boss for this one sole reason. Though, very ingenious character design, I will admit, but kind of annoying. And there goes my last life, but hey, I've got one more shot at this. Make it count. Yeah. Screw it. I don't remember how to do her last word, so let's just use it anyway. She countered the last! Ah! That was perfect, too, and I could've just... Oh, that would've been such a good way to end off the video, but... Oh, that was stupid. That would've been such a good way to end it off, too. As fantasy evidence, one of the most powerful moves, it was such a perfect way to end it off, but... I don't know what happens if you get negative maximum, though. It's never happened to anyone in a match that I've played. And end credits. I wish I could skip these, but you can't skip it the first time through. Ugh. Anyway, these will be divided up into separate episodes. For each one, I will be clearing one story, so yeah. These are like the end credits, so yeah. I hope you, dear viewer, enjoy the video. That was the first part of, I think there are 12 characters total, so 12 parts. Yeah. Just want to do a short little series to fill in gaps while I'm waiting for 100 subscribers so I can do that Minecraft survival I promised. So yeah, I hope you, dear viewer, enjoyed that video. No. Guess that's it. See you in the next episode, next part, or whatever I'm gonna name it. Yeah, it's been a while since I've done recordings. Long while. Hope you enjoyed the video, dear viewer. And see you next time.